12 run, 3 phase 4154, 37.3 kilowatt. Data collected order data, efficiency 90%, power 0.8 lagging. So we have to find the line guard and phase guard. So firstly, we have to calculate the input power. This 37.3 is the output power. So output divided by efficiency, 37.3 into 10 power 3 divided by 0.9. So this is for the output power. Output power equal to, this is the, now we call the input power. So input power equal to root 3 EI cos phi. So I square to the power divided by root 3 E cos phi. So then we substitute power is at 373 multiplying 10 power 3 because of the kilowatt. The root 3 is at 1 by 7321. For the E is at 4150. And power factor 0.88. And this is efficiency 0.9. So the line current is at 65 by 5 ampere. So phase current, so data connection. So line current by root 3. 65 by 5 divided by 1 by 7321. So you call it 37.8 ampere. So based on the, those are three phase principle for example, you have to study. Topic 6, apparent real reactive power. Study the slide 1 to 4. Do the exercises. Question 1 to question 3. Topic 7, 3 phase voltage. Study the slide 1 to 6. Do the exercises. Question 4 to 5. Topic 8, start data load. Study slide 1 to 16. Do the exercises. Question 6 to question 12. So today's lesson is an inter-time relay. So they are the electrical current in the passing through the two parallel conductor. The force between the two conductor can be calculated. F is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 I by D. I is a current, and D is a distance between the two conductor. The unit is a newton per meter. So this is for the two coil. Coil 1 got the number of time N1. Coil 2 got the number of time N2. E1 is a voltage produced in coil 1. E2 is a voltage Y2. E1 can be calculated N1 multiplied D5 by DT. So N1 is the number of times, E1 is the voltage, D5 by DT is the rate of change of the flux. Similarly, E2 can be calculated N2 into D5 by DT. So that we solve this problem. A transformer has a 50 turns on the primary and 600 turns on the secondary. The flux 0.25 waver is induced in a 5 millisecond. We have to calculate the voltage each one. So we write down the equation E1 is equal to the N1. Multiply D5 by DT. So number of time, 1 is a 50, flux is a 0.25 waver, time is a 5 milliseconds, 5 into 10 power minus 3, so you got a 2500 volt. E2 is equal to N2 into D5 by DT. So number of time, 2 is a 600, flux is a 0.25, time is a 5 into 10 power minus 3, so you got a 13,000 volt. So this is the construction of the relay. Relay got the coil, electrical current flow to this coil. This one called as a magnetization, so that it attracts the motive ion. So this is the terminal. So we have to provide the DC voltage to the relay. So this relay wire attracts as a normally open contact and a normally closed contact. So that we utilize a practical application of electromagnet in a generator, motor, transformer, and the relay wires. So production of the electromagnetic circuit here. So when the electrical current passing through, this currents are produced the flux in the disk coil. So this coil are become the magnet so that it can attract the ion. So today's lesson is an inter-time relay. So they are the electrical current in the passing through the two parallel conductor. The force between the two conductor can be calculated. F is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 I by D. I is a current, and D is a distance between the two conductor. The unit is a newton per meter. So this is for the two coil. Coil 1 got the number of time N1, coil 2 got the number of time N2. E1 is a voltage produced in coil 1, E2 is a voltage produced in coil 2. E1 can be calculated N1 multiplied D5 by DT. So N1 is the number of times, E1 is a voltage, D5 by DT is a rate of change of the flux. Similarly, E2 can be calculated N2 into D5 by DT. So that we solve this problem. A transformer has a 50 turns on the primary and 600 turns on the secondary. The flux 0.25 waver is induced in a 5 millisecond. We have to calculate the voltage each one. So we write down the equation E1 is equal to the N1 multiplied by D5 by DT. So number of time, 1 is a 50, flux is a 0.25 waver, time is a 5 millisecond, 5 into 10 power minus 3, so you got a 2500 volt. E2 is equal to N2 into D5 by DT. So number of time, 2 is a 600, flux is a 0.25, time is a 5 into 10 power minus 3, so you got a 13,000 volt. So this is the construction of the relay. already got a coil, electrical current flow to this coil. This one got some magnetization, so that it attracts some molybdenum ion. So this is a terminal. So we have to provide a DC voltage to the relay. So this relay wire attracts a normally open voltage and a normally closed voltage. So that we utilize a practical application of electromagnet in a generator, motor, transformer, and the relay wires. So conduction of the electromagnetic circuit here. So when the electrical current passing through, these currents are flow through the flux in the disk coil. So this coil are become the magnet so that it can attract the ion. So this problem, 3-phase 4154 37.3 kW, data collected order data, efficiency 90%, power flux 0.8 lagging. So we have to find the line current and phase current. So firstly we have to calculate the input power. This 37.3 is the output power. So output divided by efficiency, 37.3 into 10 power 3 divided by 0.9. So this is for the output power. Output power equal to, this is the, now we call the input power. So input power equal to root 3 EI cos phi. So I square to the power divided by root 3 E cos phi. So then we substitute power is 373 multiplied by 10 power 3 because of the kilowatt. The root 3 is 1 by 7321. Voltage E is a 4150. And power factor 0.88. And this is efficiency 0.9. So the line current is a 65 by 5 ampere. So phase current, so data connection. Line current by root 3, 65 by 5 divided by 1 by 7321, so you got the 37.8 ampere. So based on those are three phase principle board example, you have to study. Topic 6, apparent real reactive power, study the slide 1 to 4, do the exercises, question 1 to question 3. Topic 7, 3-phase voltage, study the slide 1 to 6, do the exercises, question 4 to 5. Topic 8, start data load. Study slide 1 to 16. Do the exercises. Question 6 to question 12. So this problem, a series circuit is connected to a 10 volt IMA AC supply. The circuit has a resistor 100 ohm. Inductive reactor is a 300 ohm. Capacity reactor is 400 ohm. 5. A impedance, B current, C the phase angle, D the voltage draw across the resistor, E is a voltage draw across the inductor, S a voltage draw across the capacitor. So this is resistor 100 ohm, inductive reactor 300 ohm, capacitor reactor 400 ohm. So they are all in series connected to across a 10 volt IMS. Impedance can be calculated square root of R square plus HA minus AC the whole square, tangent inverse HA minus AC by R. So the R is 100, HA is 300, AC 400. So do this substitute, we calculate to the impedance 141 and get minus 45. So do the current V by Z. Voltage 10, say is 141, so 0.071 ampere. Total angle 5 is 45 degrees. So the current flow to the resistor, VR, I multiply R. So I 0.071, resistor 100, so 7.1 volt. VN, I multiply HA. Current 0.071, inductive reactor is 300, so 21.3 volt. VC, I multiply AC. So the currents are 0.071, capacity reactor is 400, so 28 by 4 volt. So this is for the series resistor inductor capacitor series. We can find to the current, to the voltage, and to the impedance. So based on the those are principle, so you have to do the exercise. Topic 1, 3-phase AC circuit basic. Study the slide 1 to 14. Do the exercises from question 1 to question 15. This circuit, the supply voltage 100 volt, to the current is 0.971, power factor 0.54. So we need to calculate the total power. So the power is a VI cos phi. V voltage, I current, cos phi, power factor. So voltage 100 volt, current 0.971, power factor 0.54, so 52.431. Now we study the 3-phase circuit. The supply voltage is set from 0, Y, and go to this way. This is the A waveform. After 120 degree PV coming up, and 240 degree VC come in. So this is VA is angle 0, VBA minus 120, VC is minus 240. So we rotate in that direction. So this is for the beta diagram and waveform of the 3-phase circuit. So that this 3-phase circuit going can be connected to the star connection. So this is the star connection here. So then this is a EA phase voltage, EB phase voltage, EC phase voltage, EAB is a line voltage between A and B line, EBC is the line voltage between B and C line. EC line voltage between C and A line. IA, IB, IC are line current. So that for the star balance condition, IA equal to IB equal to IC is a phase current. EAB, EBC, ECA line voltage equal to root 3 EA phase voltage equal to root 3 EB phase voltage equal to root 3 EC phase voltage. So this is the phase voltage and current for the star car connection. So we could also connect it to the data connection. So in this case, this is the IAB phase current, IBC phase current, ICA phase current. IA, IB, IC are line current. So that for the data connection, phase voltage and line voltage are the same. Line current IA, IB, IC equal to root 3 IAB phase current, root 3 IBC phase current, root 3 ICA phase current. So line currents are root 3 times the phase current. So power can be calculated root 3 EI cos phi. So this problem, the phase voltage and current in the 3 phase star, phase voltage are the 240 volt and current is 50 ampere. Find the line voltage, line current. So phase voltage for the star connection, the line voltage is equal to 3 phase voltage. 1 by 7321 multiplied by 240, so 415 volt. And line current and phase current are the same, 50 ampere. Another problem, a data connected loop takes a line current 40 ampere, line voltage 415 volt. A phi is a phase current, is a phase voltage. So the phase current is equal to the line current by root 3, so the line current 40 divided by root 3, so the 40 by root 3, so 1 by 7321, so 23.1 ampere. Phase voltage and line voltage are the same, 415 volt. Electrical installation safety testing. When you finish the electrical wiring job for the any building, so we have to test the electrical installation safety. So there are three testing techniques. Testing technique one is an IP system. Testing technique two is an insulation system. And testing technique three is a polarity test. So IP system is provided for the electrical system. When the any leakage happens from the metal is put down, so the those leakages are electrocute the feedback, so the same leakage can be diverted to the adding system. Leakage need to be diverted to the ground, so this is the leakage system. So adding system have to be test. In the meantime, all the insulator system between the anti conductor and neutral conductor, anti conductor and out conductor should be test, and also the anti conductor to the ground wire you have to test. Another one is the polarity testing. Polarity testing means that normally this is left side the anti, right side the neutral. Bottom one is out. So the active and neutral must not be the reverse. All the switch must be connected to the active wire. And therefore, the whether the wiring is the correct piece of polarity or not, so we have to test. So all the active wire must be connected to the switch. And left side is the active, right side is the neutral. So active and neutral must not be reversed. Similarly, there is a loose ground position between the out and neutral wire. Therefore, we have to test the adding system, we have to test the insulator system, we have to test the polarity test. Okay, topic one, we use testing technique one, adding system. So, how we make the adding system? Firstly, this is the neutral link, this is the adding. We have to remove the connection between the neutral link and adding. So, this is the ambient, main address neutral. This link has to be removed. We have to switch off the supply. Then, we take out the all wire from the connected to the neutral wire, so we have to test. So we have one mega ohmmeter connected to the electrode, and another terminal connected to the ambient link terminal. So in this case, this resistor must be less than 2 ohm. So this is the active wire, and this is the electrode. So this, between this resistor from the electrode to the ambient connection link, we have to test the resistor. This resistor less than 2 ohm. After that, you also need to test the connection. So this is a 3-pin point. Here is the A connection. So we have to switch off the all supply. By the circuit, another thing is isolated. So the isolated supply, take off the neutral link. So one, this is the ohmmeter. So ohmmeter is a one ohmmeter, one terminal. We connected to the at point of the switch socket outlet. Another terminal connected to the ambient drive. So the dual resistor must be less than 2 ohm. So this is the way that we can test it out. So that this wire is that we can simplify the diagram. So this is the neutral wire here, this is the active wire, this is the up. So that this is for the ohmmeter. Ohmmeter connected to the main up connection, and ohmmeter connected to the up terminal of the socket outlet. So this resistor must be the 2 ohm. So this diagram and this diagram the same. This is the rear star correlation star testing diagram. So this is for the star static correlation diagram. In the meantime, star, we also need to test the arc continuity. When we are using the star steel coil is the front and main sway bolt and the steel coil here and the appliance. So normally star, at the main sway bolt, the arc correlation is connected to the main sway bolt. But this steel coil must have the continuity of the arc. So then we have to use the ohmmeter. While ohmmeter one terminal connected to the main arc terminal, and we have to adjust the analog point to the appliance, the coil connection point, so all the points you connect, so those the system need to be less than 2 ohms. So this is the way that we can test the continuity of the RD system. Another one is that we have to test the insulation system between the active and neutral wire, active and the R wire. Those insulation system must be the infinity or the very high insulation system. So this is the method to test the insulation system. So firstly, we take out the main supply and neutral. We make the connection between main supply and neutral. And then choose elements are we have to place. But that's all that we have to take out the wire from the neutral wire. So this is all the activities are take out. So we have to put the ambient connection disconnected. We put the mega ohmmeter. 1 mega ohmmeter at the neutral link, another at the R link. So this neutral link and R link, the resistor must be infinity. Okay, I explain it. We take off the main supply at the neutral wire, and this is the main switch, this is the main circuit breaker. Main switch and the main circuit breaker, two elements, everything are on. So the circuit is a main supply, connected with the supply, but the main supply is disconnected. This neutral link, the connection between neutral link and R link is disconnected. Then ohmmeter, one terminal placed at the neutral link, another terminal placed at the R link. So we measure the resistor must be infinity. So this is the testing or insulation system for complete installation. So these are the basis of electrical wiring. Firstly, I will talk about this cable and the cable pool. So then electrical basic wiring cables are they have single core, two core, three core, four core, and flexible core. They are the 5 kind of the cable. For the single core, there's a core colors with the red or the black. For the two core, red and black or red and white. Three cores are the red, white, blue. Four core is a red, white, blue, and black. So in this case, for the three core, red, white, blues are for the active conductor. Four core cables, red, white, and blues are active, and the black for the neutral conductor. Flexible cores can be the gray and yellow is the arc, brown with the active conductor, and the light blue for the neutral conductor. So this is the color codings of the cable. So that we have to utilize the appropriate cable for the appropriate active, neutral, or the arc wire connection. Okay, now that we can see this, this is for the power distribution cable. So this is for the armor cable. Armor cable is this is the conductor here. Conductor is surrounded by the imbricated paper insulation, and they are surrounded by the screen metal tape. And here we have the filler with the filler inserted between the core, and they are covered by the armor layer, and finally with the serving layer. So this is for the pair conductor. Those conductors are for the underground cable conductors, and pair conductors are utilized with the copper and aluminum. Copper and aluminum are used for the construction of the bare conductor. Bare conductor for the transmission line system. Okay, this is for the flexible cable here. Normally, we call the three core. So, three core are double insulation. This is insulator. It's surrounded by the insulation, and then another insulation. So, this is the TPS cable, thermoplastic sheet cable. The thermoplastic sheet cables are widely utilized for the whole electrical wiring system. So, they are made with the double insulation. For the high temperature system, we use the MIMS cable, minus insulated metallic sheet cable. So this is the MIMS cable. So this one is the conductor. Conductor is surrounded by the compressor binary insulation. In this case, we are utilizing the manganese dioxide insulation, and they are surrounded by the solid drop cover sheet, and the final layer which is a PVC layer. So this is the MIMS cables are useful for the high temperature application, especially for the oven or the electric furnace, high temperature we can use. So that they can withstand up to 1100 degrees centigrade temperature. So This is a controller lighting circuit. Normally, we utilize the switch at the edit controller. So this is the edit controller here, switch, and this is the light, and this is the neutral. So this is the single pulse control. So single pulse control only cut off the edit wire line. Now we use the double pole control. The double pole control is it can cut off the both edit and neutral wire. So this is a typical home wiring circuit connection. So this is edit wire coming here, go to switch. So this one go to the other line. So this is the out wire go to another main. So this is the edit wire go to the left. So this go to here. So this one go to the neutral. So this neutral go to the another line. So this is for the looping at the bending holder. And here is the looping and the switch. Edit wire go here, to edit wire to switch off, so this is light. So this is the neutral wire. So this is edit wire, so this is for the looping at the neutral wire. So when we are using the switch here, so this terminal, so you guys usually see the three terminal. So this is for the common terminal, so this is the two light, and this is the looping terminal. So this is for the switch, at the back of the switch, you can see the terminal like this. So those are the basic electrical stuff. Wiring circuit diagram for the home electrical wiring system. This is the electrical wiring diagram for the power outlet. So edit go here, this edit go to the another line. So this edit wire go to the edit. So this here is a neutral wire, go to neutral, plug neutral and go to another line. So out wire go to here. So this is the plug is a left side ever edit, right side neutral, and the middle point will be out. So also we can also connect like this. In this case, this is the edit wire come here, go to another line. So the edit wire go to switch. This is coming out, go to the edit wire. And this is for the out wire, go to another line. And neutral wire here, so this neutral wire go to this line, and this one go to the plug. So this is that we can utilize the looping at the plug, and this is the looping at the this is the cable drive. So this is for the connector. This is a two-way switch system. Two-way switch system where it is this way, two switch, two-way switch. So we can one switch on, so we can cut off the light by the another switch. So two-way switch ever got a common terminal and terminal 1-2. Terminal 1-2 need to be connected parallel. Common terminal is connected to the incoming line and outgoing line. So those are the simplified circuit diagram for the whole electrical wiring. So we use as a poles are connected. Connector 1 connected to the incoming black and go to another line. Connector 2, the connector 2 is connected to the switch. So the green wire go to the connector 3, go to another line. And from the red wire go to the connector 4, go to another line. So connector 4 is connected to switch, the switch connected to the connector. Connector 4 is connected to switch, and this switch connected to connector 2. So from the connector 1 and 2, between 1 and 2, we place a line. This is the one switch control at one line. So this is most simplified diagram. We can use the four connector. Connector 1, 2, 3, 4. So black wire go to connector 1, go to another line. Green wire go to connector 3, go to another line. Red wire go to connector 4, go to another line. So connector 4 connected to switch. Switch connected to the front switch connected to connector 2. So between connector 1 and 2, we place a line. Now here is a switch and plug connection. We also use the four connector, 1, 2, 3, 4 connector. So the black wire go to connector 1, go to another line. Green wire go to connector 3, go to another line. Red wire go to connector 4, go to another line. So connector 4 connected to light. Connector 4 connected to switch. Switch connected to the edit. From the connector 1 connected to neutral wire, and from the green connected to the out. So this is the switch and plug connection. So that in the electrical wiring diagram, those are connections that we put in the control. So this is the incoming line, this is for the socket plug, and this is outgoing line. Here we use the control. Control we use the control PVC control, and we connect with the D junction. So this is the installation diagram of the control diagram. So this circuit, the supply voltage 100 volt, so the current is 0.971/0.54. So we need to calculate the total power. So the power is a VI cos phi. V voltage, I current cos phi power factor. So voltage 100 volt, current 0.971, power factor 0.54, so 52.43 watt. Now we study the three-phase circuit. So supply voltage is start from 0, Y, and go to this way. This is the A waveform. after 120 degree VV coming up and 240 degree VC coming. So this is VAs are angle 0, VVA minus 120, VCs are minus 240. So we rotate in that direction. So this is for the beta diagram and waveform three phase circuit. So that this three phase circuit going can be connected to the star connection. So this is the star connection here. So then this is set up EA phase voltage, EB phase voltage, EC phase voltage. EAB is a line voltage between A and B line. EBC is a line voltage between B and C line. EC is a line voltage between C and A line. IA, IB, IC is a line current. So then, for the star balance condition, IA equal to IB equal to IC is a phase current. EAB, EBC, ECA line voltage equal to root 3 EA phase voltage equal to root 3 EB phase voltage equal to root 3 EC phase voltage. So this is the phase voltage and current for the star car condition. So we can also connect it to the data connection. So in this case, this is the IAB phase current, IBC phase current, ICA phase current, IA, IB, IC are line current. So that for the data connection, phase voltage and line voltage are the same. Line current IA, IB, IC equal to root 3 IAB phase current, root 3 IBC phase current, root 3 ICA phase current. So line currents are root 3 times the phase current. So power can be calculated root 3 EI cos phi. So this problem. The phase voltage and current in the three-phase star, phase voltage are the 240 volt and current 50 ampere. Find the line voltage, line current. So phase voltage for the star condition, the line voltage is equal to 3 phase voltage, 1 by 7321 multiplied by 240, so 415 volt. And line current and phase current are the same, 50 ampere. Another problem, the data connected loop takes a line current 40 ampere, line voltage 415 volt. A phi is a phase current, is a phase voltage. So the phase current is equal to the line current by root 3, so the line current 40 divided by root 3, so the 40 by root 3, so 1 by 7321, so 23 by 1 ampere. Phase voltage and line voltage are the same, 4154. So now that we connect the resistor and inductor in series, so the voltage drop when the electrical current I flowing, the resistor and inductor is HL, inductor reactor is HL. So that when the current flows to the resistor, so VR, I into R is a resistor. Voltage across a resistor. So I into HA is a voltage across a inductor. So then we can calculate the total voltage. Total voltage VD squared square root of VR squared plus VI squared. So this is the way we can calculate the current voltage across a resistor and inductor series. Okay, so now we solve this problem. A 64 mH inductor is connected in series with a 300 ohm resistor to a 1000 Hz AC current. Voltage of 10 volt IMS. Phi is an impedance, B the phase angle, C that the current, D that the potential drop across a resistor, E the potential drop across an inductor. So resistor is 300 ohm, inductor is 64 mH. Both of them are connected in series to the 10 volts of IMS, 1.5. So firstly, you have to calculate the inductive reactance. So inductive value is given as 64 mH. So the inductive reactance can be calculated. HL is equal to 2 by FL. 2 multiply 3.1416 multiply frequency 1000 and the inductance. Inductance is 64 mH. So substitute 64 here. 64 into 10 power minus 3. So this is the inductive reactance. So reactance can be calculated. So that will be that 400 ohm. So inductive reactance is 400 ohm. So impedance can be calculated square root of R squared plus HL squared, tangent inverse HL by R. So resistor 300, inductor you substitute as 400, and inductive tangent inverse are 400 by 300, so you got the 500 angle, 53 by 2 ohm. So this becomes the impedance is 500 ohm, phase angle is 53 by 2 degree. Current can be calculated, voltage divided by impedance. So voltage is 10 angle 0, then move RMS. Impedance we already calculate 500 angle 53 by 2. So there will be the 0.02 angle minus 53 by 2 ampere or 20 milliampere. So voltage across a resistor, I multiply R. I 8.02 ampere, resistor is 300, so you call it 6 volt. Voltage across an inductor, I multiply HA. So that will be the 0.02 multiply 400, you call it 8 volt. Then we draw the beta diagram. We are 6 volt. VA is 8 volt, so phase angle 53 by 2, so the total voltage will get 10 volt. So this is for the solution for the resistor and inductor series circuit problem. another problem. Find the current in the garden when an AC voltage tempo RMS at 1000 Hz is applied to 2 microfarad capacitor. So AC is equal to 1 by 2 by SC. We calculate capacitor in feedback, so capacitor reactor can be calculated. So 1 by 2 by 3 by 1416 frequency 1000 and then capacitor. So this is 2 microfarad. 2 microfarad, so multiply with 2 into 10 power minus 6. So that by solving this one, you can get is a 79.5 ohm. So the current can be calculated, voltage divided by capacitor reactor. So voltage is a 10 volt divided by 79.5, so 0.125 ampere. So this is for the current drawn by capacitor. Okay, another problem. A 1 microfarad capacitor is connected in series with 200 ohm resistor to 10 volt RMS, 1600 supply. 1600 Hz supply. So phi is the impedance with the phase angle, see the current with the potential drop across the resistor, E potential drop across the capacitor. So this is the supply voltage 10 volt frequency 1600 Hz connected. So the resistor 200 ohm, capacitor 1 microfarad. So firstly we calculate the capacitor reactant, 1 by 2 by FC. 1 divided by 2 by 3 by 1416 frequencies are 1600 Hz. Capacitor once a microfarad. So you can calculate. So then by this way you calculate the AC 100 ohm. So impedance there is square root of R square plus AC square. So minus 10 inverse AC by R and gain. So then square root of resistor 200 square, capacitor reactance are 100 square. Minus 10 inverse 100 by 200. So AC 100, R is 200. So you call the thing is a 223.6 and get minus 26.5 ohm. So impedance there is a 223.6 ohm and get phi is minus 26.5 degree. So current can be calculated for voltage divided by impedance. Voltage is 10 volt, impedance is 223.6 and get minus 26.5. So answer is 50448 and get 26.5 ampere. So voltage across the resistor, I multiply R. So current is 0.448, resistor is a 200 ohm, so you got a 9 ohm. Voltage across the capacitor, I multiply AC. Current is a 0.448, and so capacitor reactant is 100 ohm, so you got a 4 by 4844. So this is the way the resistor and capacitor series circuit. We can calculate the total impedance, total current and voltage drop across the resistor and capacitor. Okay, we talk about this one. Resistor, capacitor, and inductor in series. So here is a resistor, inductor, capacitor connected in series to the supply voltage VD. So the voltage across the resistor is VR, voltage across the inductor is VA, voltage across the capacitor is VC. VR equal to I multiply R, VA is I multiply HL, VC is I multiply AC. So impedance there. When the H is greater than AC, impedance there is equal to R plus J. HL minus AC. When the AC is greater than HL, Z is equal to R minus J, AC minus HL. So we can calculate the total voltage VD. VD equal to square root of VR square plus VL minus VC square. Tangent phi is HL minus AC by R. When the HL is greater than AC, this angle is minus phi and negative. And tangent phi, AC minus HL by R. When the AC is greater than HL, so the intensity I is V by the minus Z minus angle phi. So the V by Z plus phi. So this is the leading. For the lagging, V divided by the Z angle phi. So the I is going to V by Z angle minus phi lagging. So the when the AC is greater than AC, angle is a lagging. AC greater than AC, angle leading. So power factor is cos phi. Sine wave is its value. So this is the sine wave. Sine wave start from the zero. And this is it reaches a maximum at the 90 degree of pi by 2, and it goes back to the 0 at the 180 degree of pi, and there's a minus maxima at the 270 degree, and it's reached the 0 again at the 360 degree at the 2 pi. So this is for the waveform on the sine wave. So any instantaneous value, so between this waveform, this value, are instantaneous value. We can calculate that the formula is the peak value multiplied by theta. And RMS value means the you use the voltmeter and measure the voltage across the power, find the dead voltage is the IMS value. IMS value formula is P value divided by root 2 or 0.707 multiplied with frequency. And frequency. Frequency is how many waveform, how many cycles within the 1 second. So this is the frequency. The frequency can be calculated 1 divided by time. Time means that this is all that this is the period time. 1 second. So time taken to travel the 1 second is the time. So the frequency is equal to 1 divided by time. So by this way we can calculate the frequency. So the weakest are draw the waveform. So this is the Fourier waveform here, dotted line, and current waveform is that this is the current waveform. So Fourier and current are start at the same point and at the same point. In this case, we can write down the current formula. I angle 0. 0 means that there is a no phase difference between the Fourier and current. Okay, so current is coming after the Fourier. So phi. So this is the I minus phi. This means the current is coming after the Fourier or lagging current. If the current is coming in front of the voltage, so this is the forward. So this is the positive phi. Positive phi is the forward value. So in this case, the I positive phi. So this is the leading current. So because of this, we saw that when the current is coming after the voltage, so at the phi is lagging, you can draw the beta diagram. This is the voltage, and this is the current, so again minus phi, beta rotate in this way. When the current in front of the voltage, plus phi. This is leading current, so then this is voltage here, this is current, so this is angle is positive phi. The beta rotate in that direction. So then this is for the we can write down the lagging and the leading current in the AC circuit. And now that we will stop of the phase addition. Voltage V1 the direction, voltage V2 is the direction. So then this is the start point, this is final ending point. We join this with this one, start and the final ending point, so this is the V1 plus V2 beta. The current flow into the electrical circuit, it can also create this electrical power. It can also happen with electrical power. So power is equal to VI cos phi. Voltage multiply current multiply cos phi. Or power is equal to I square R, or the power is equal to V square by R. So this is the way that we can calculate the electrical power. So now we talk about the series AC circuit. Resistor and inductor are connected in series. The combination is impedance Z. Impedance Z can be calculated square root of R square plus HN square. HN is an inductive reactance. HN can be calculated 2 by FN. 2 multiplied by multiply. F is a frequency and is an inductive reactance. So the Z equal to square root of R square plus HN square. Tangent inverse H by R. So this is the phase angle between the resistor and inductor. And similarly, when you connect the resistor and the capacitor in the series, so we can also calculate the capacitive reactance 1 divided by 2 by FC. So 2 pi by 3 by 1 for 1 say FC the frequency, the capacitive value is the frequent farad. So the impedance Z can be calculated square root of R square plus AC square and get minus tangent inverse AC by R. For the resistor in the series, Z can be calculated by this formula. And resistor and capacitor series, we can calculate themselves by this formula. Okay, we solve this problem. A sine wave voltage of the 244 IMS is applied to a resistance circuit of the 60 ohm. Calculate IMS value of current, maximum of value of the current. So this is the 200 volt supply, this is resistor 60 ohm. So then, in this case, there is no inductor, no capacitor, only the resistor. So I is going to be by R. Voltage 240, resistance 60. So the current is 4 ampere. So this is the 4 ampere is the IMS value. If you want to find the maximum value, this IMS is multiplied with root 2. So that 1 by 4, 1, 4, 2 into 4, so 5.65 ampere. This is the maximum value. So this is for the R maximum can be calculated. 1 by 4, 1, 4, 2 into IMS value. Another problem, equal of the negligible resistance. Draw a current on the 0.2 ampere IMS when connected to a 244 50 hertz. You have to determine the quad inductance, inductive reactance, quad inductance, draw the voltage current phasor diagram. So this is for the resistor here, supply, this is the quad. So firstly, we have to calculate HA is going to be right I. So voltage 240, current is 0.2, so 1200 volt. Okay, HA can be calculated 2 by FA, so A is a HA by 2 by F. So HA is a 1200, 2 by, and then F is a frequency 50, so you got a 3.81 Henry. So voltage 240 volt, the current 0.2 ampere, when you connect the inductor, that will be the lagging current is at 90 degrees.